Ladies and gentlemen, it is with the utmost pleasure that I now introduce you to our first speaker, Dr. Tamsin Ramsey, a tireless advocate for animals of all species. Dr. Ramsey worked as a Melbourne paramedic before earning her doctorate in medical anthropology. She then worked at the United Nations in New York, raising awareness of our climate emergency, caused in large part by animal industries who breed, hurt, and kill those animals, such as the live export trade. Dr. Ramsey is a published academic, an executive producer of the animal rights documentary Dominion, and has been a guest speaker at many conferences around the world, addressing the problems of animal agriculture and climate change. Dr. Ramsey was brought up in Albert Park, where she is running as a candidate in the next state election. She also believes in a hands-on style of compassion and is a proud foster carer with Lamb Care Australia, who rescue and care for and find homes for some of the 15 million lambs who are bred and left to die in Australian paddocks every year. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Dr. Tamsin Ramsey.
The live export industry is not the problem. There are many industries that hurt and kill animals, and they all need to stop. But today we are here to focus on just one of those many, and that is the live export industry. Today we are talking about sheep and we are talking about ships. We are talking about hundreds of millions of animals over decades in an industry that has never been humane. I'm not suggesting the people in it are intrinsically bad, but the actual business model requires that animals be bred, hurt, and killed for money to be made. That is the bald reality. I imagine everyone who saw the footage was affected, yet we can still perceive those sheep as one group rather than a series of individuals. But thanks to organisations like Lamb Care Australia, every now and then some sheep are saved and their lives become known. Two of those lives are Ruby and Harley, and I'm here to speak for them and others like them. Ruby was found shivering and near dead in a paddock. She came to me when she was 1 week old. I held this little lamb in my arms, and as she nibbled my ear and pooed on my floor, I was overwhelmed with affection and trepidation. I thought, how on earth do I look after a one-week-old lamb? I knew nothing. Anyway, like most youngsters, they will let you know what they need. So I fed her when she was hungry. I cuddled her when she wanted love. I played with her every morning, and I chilled out with her in the evenings. And I loved her morning, croaky, sleepy, I had a week of training from Ruby before Harley arrived at my door. Harley was smaller. He was more anxious, louder, and less confident than Ruby. At mealtimes, Ruby would come to me, but Harley would stand to one side and bleat. Ruby would grab the bottle teat, and Harley couldn't quite grab it. Ruby would lie between my legs on the couch, whereas Harley wanted to be held close. He would nestle in my hair and nibble at my face. He was just not as confident as Ruby. All of this was such a learning experience for me. I knew nothing about lambs, so I looked to them to teach me. And the following lesson was a particularly beautiful one. So I live in a two-story townhouse, and Ruby loved the stairs. At 1 week old, she would run up the stairs, and at 9 days old, she could run down the stairs. However, Harley was not game. When I would go upstairs, Ruby would follow me, and Harley would wait down below and bleat. I would go down to get him, and I'd carry him up in my arms. This continued every day for a week. Then one morning, something different happened. I went upstairs, and for the first time, Ruby didn't follow me. I heard Harley's familiar bleat. I turned around, and Ruby was standing next to Harley. She put her hoofs on the bottom step and made a little baa sound to Harley. Harley followed her example and put his hoofs on the first step. Then Ruby got on the second step and looked at Harley, giving him a gentle baa. It was clear he wanted to do it, but he just couldn't do it. He was just too anxious. So he bleated again, and I went and picked him up again, and we all went upstairs together. So this was the start of what was clearly a relationship of friendship and support between Ruby and Harley. Over the next 10 days, oh, the mic's better now. Over the next 10 days, or I'm better, I watched as Ruby encouraged Harley. She would show him what to do, walk alongside him, or just stay with him when he was feeling anxious. And I watched as Harley grew in confidence day by day, until the day finally came when, with Ruby by his side at every step, Harley made it up the stairs. And this was a cause for great celebration. There were bars, cheers, and lamb hugs all around. So not long after that, I took them to their new home in the country where they would live the rest of their natural lives. This place had older sheep, a cat, and some chickens. Until then, Harley and Ruby had only ever seen each other and humans. So being approached by older sheep, cats, and chickens was quite a scene. But suddenly, what was interesting is the tables turned and Ruby was suddenly the shy one. Seeing the chicken, Ruby ran behind Harley for safety. While Harley approached all the other animals, met them each one by one with this kind of newfound playful confidence. I tell you, I miss them. I miss their smells, I miss their sounds, I miss their personalities. So I wanted to mention Ruby and Harley because it reminds us that all of these sheep are individuals. They're bright, they're funny, they're moral, playful, intelligent. They are complex individuals who build relationships and who have fears, wants, and rights. Their lives matter to them, and the lives of others matter to them, and their lives matter to us. We have to stop breeding them. We have to stop shipping them overseas to be hurt and killed. Ultimately, we have to wrap up all the animal hurting industries. But as a definitive first step, let's please put a final end to this live export industry. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Dr. Tamsin Ramsey.